gonna be a long one. What's up, everybody? It's Margo, and I'm back with another video. Today, we are going to be doing book haul number 2. This one is huge, and when I mean huge, I mean I have books dating back to Christmas. First up, this series, this 4-book series, was happily gifted to me by one of my best friends, Vix. Hey! I don't really know anything about this series. Vix just told me that they really loved it and that they thought I would enjoy it too, but that they knew they weren't going to read it anytime soon, so they just gave it to me instead. So it seems like Alice in Wonderland meets Zombie Apocalypse. Next one up is Hold Me Closer by David Levithan. This was also lovingly gifted to me by my friend Kennedy. Hey! She said she really enjoyed it and that she thought I would enjoy it too. Up next, more gifts. This was actually gifted to me on Valentine's Day by my friend Jessica. Hey! She was looking around the dollar store and was looking for things to get me because me, Jess, Kennedy, and our other friend Ida actually do a gift exchange every holiday where we use, I think it's drawyourname.com or something, and we draw each other's names, so it's almost like a Secret Santa, but for Valentine's Day as well as Christmas. It's called Marked for Life by Emily Shepp, and it looks like it's a crime thriller. And Jess knows that I love crime, which is why this was very fitting. Moving on, we have The Wicked King by Holly Black, which is the sequel to The Cruel Prince. Now, when I bought this, I didn't know that. My friend Amanda was pestering me to read this. She raved at me for at least 2 weeks. And I just finally buckled down after her constant nagging, and I read it. Now, I got 40 pages in, and I realized I didn't know what was going on, and I started reading it on a school morning in like first period because she wanted me to start reading it right away. So what I had done was I went to Target with my gift card because I needed to use the gift card. I texted her a picture. I said, "Hey, is this the book?" She said, "Yeah, that's the book." I bought it. I walked into school, and I was so confused because there were all of these character names that I didn't know and all of these like hints at relations and I didn't know what was going on. So I just looked at the book and I said, "You have a lot of explaining to do." And to quote, she said, "Oh no, oh no, oh no, you didn't." And I said, "I didn't what?" She said, "That's the second book." And I said, "Well, no wonder." Long story short, she helped me check out The Cruel Prince from our school's library. I read it. I enjoyed it enough to read this one. I enjoyed it enough to want to read Queen of Nothing whenever it comes out. Ooh. Up next, we have Heartless by Marissa Meyer. Now, I've actually already read this on audiobook, which, by the way, I highly recommend you read it on audiobook because it is so well voiced. It is so well voiced, it's absolutely amazing. Up next we have Dread Nation by Justina Ireland, another Christmas collection. I'm really excited to read this because I know it's historical fiction, which is going to be great, and doesn't she just look so cool on the cover there? She just looks great. Up next, newly released, we have King of Scars by Leigh Bardugo. Now, the jacket's off just because I wanted to showcase the beautiful engraving of this, and the cover's everywhere, but you never really see this. I actually pre-ordered this, so I should hopefully be getting a pin in the mail soon with the King of Scars crest, which is going to be great, and so far it's pretty good. I'm less than 100 pages in, I'm at page 88. Amanda's like way far along, more than me. We're reading this at the same time because we really both love Nikolai and we really want to get to the end of it. Speaking of, by the way, back to the whole Cruel Prince thing, she and I made a parody song of it. We used the Siri voices to read my lyrics that she edited and produced, and basically what happened was I wrote this like knockoff poem that was based on Mad World to fit the Cruel Prince, and then I made the thumbnail, and then she edited everything together. She's so talented, you guys. She edited everything together and it made that, and I think it's really funny. We think it's really funny. We want to make more of that. And actually, we have another one in the works, but this time it's going to be voice acted. It's gonna be really fun, and I'm really excited because I love the I really love the lyrics that I wrote for it. It's gonna be great. Up next, we have Half Bad by Sally Green. Now, I don't have the jacket for this, and I don't really remember what it was about because this was another gift. This was from my friend Kaz. Hey, man. And I completely forgot what this is about. I guess this will be kind of like a blind read. Next, we have a freebie I got at my school library called Anthem by Ayn Rand. I was told this was very good. I think it might be a dystopia. I forgot. It's very short. Like, less than 100 pages, but it seems good. Next, this was another book I had gotten over Christmas. I got this from the library rack. Often what my school will do is that at the end of every semester, they will start handing out unused class copies of books that have gone out of demand. And they will just go around school and just give them out to people. And this was one of them. It was called Beneath a Meth Moon by Jacqueline Woodson. Second to last, we have The Book Thief by Marcus Suzak, another one from the library rack. And I've been recommended time and time again, and I've seen this book all over YA, or at least the community. And I know it's gotten a bunch of rating reviews, and I think at one point, I think it's a movie now. I don't know. I don't really stay up to date on books as much as I used to just because I haven't had the time, but I am definitely going to look into this more and I am going to read it eventually. And finally, this was a book that I got from my mom for Christmas. It's called Filmmaking for Teens. And while filmmaking isn't my primary career objective anymore, it's still something I would love to pursue while in high school, which is why I'm a part of my school's TV production class and club. It's really fun. If I don't end up using this, I'll give it to Amanda because she wants to be a big time director. And she's gonna be good at it. I can already tell. Thank you for watching. Make sure you leave a like on this video and comment down below if you have any thoughts to add. Without further ado, let us turn the page on this video and I will see you on the next chapter. Ciao!